Now I want you to understand basically few things about you. Please listen. I'm going to now introduce you to you. That's very important. Finding you to you. If you find you, you found God. If you don't find you, you have not found God. You have not found anything. You don't know what is joy. You don't know what is pain. You don't know what is pleasure. If you don't know you, how will you know what is your pain and what is your pleasure? What is good for you? What is bad for you? You will only have the rough idea about what is good for you, what is bad for you from others, not from you. I tell you, anything which you don't want to face in your life is because you don't know you. You don't know you. I'm introducing you to you. I am trying to create a paint drawing, all of us together. Listen, whatever you think about you inside you, whatever you believe strongly as you inside you, is inner image. Whatever you think as you inside you is inner image. If you see sometime, you will feel you will be always successful in everything. If you see sometime, you will feel you will always be failure in everything. Whatever you think as you in you is your inner image. How you show you to others How you show yourself to others, that is outer image. That is outer image. Understand? Whatever you show as you to others, usually you show through your words, body language, the way you project you, that is outer image. Mostly this inner image and outer image will be inconsistent. They will not be matching with each other. Inner image will be lower than what you are, outer image will be higher than what you are. There will be a big gap. What you think as, what you feel as you, and what you speak as you, this gap, the gap between your mouth and the heart, that is what I call confusion in life. Anyhow, I can say anyway, source of confusion. This inner image, outer image, then what others perceive about you, whatever you may show, people will have their own ideas about you. They will perceive you in their own way. That is called others' image. That is called other's image. Inner image, outer image, other's image. How others perceive you. And please listen, when you want all the benefits from others and society, you are bound to take responsibility for how others perceive you. You can't say, how others perceive me, I am not responsible for that. No. You can't say that. You are responsible for how others perceive you. You are responsible for how others perceive you. So understand, how others perceive you, others' image, you are responsible. And how you perceive the world and life, what you have in your head about life. You may think life is exploiting, all the four-letter words you may have about life and others. That is called life image. Understand, if you have a wrong life image, even if you are living in a palace with all the pleasures of life, best things life and others can give you, you will still continue to be in a deeply deprived space and state, because able to have a right life image and trust others is one of the luxury you can have in life. Being careful is different. Constantly being frightened is different. Being careful is different. Constantly being frightened is different. I'll give you experiential explanation about these four words: inner image, outer image, others' image, and life image. From my own experience, listen. When I look inside me, my inner image, I see a vast, powerful space of Purnatva, complete completion, or Sunyatva, emptiness, living emptiness. You can call that as a soul, God, energy, Mahadeva, whatever. A complete space. That's the exact inner image I'm carrying. Outer image. Listen. Outer image. How I project myself. I'm projecting myself as a being to transmit that experience to all of you. You can call us an enlightened master or a teacher or an incarnation, whatever way you want. You can give any title. I am a being to transmit that experience. That's my outer image. Declared outer image. Others' image. Listen, others' image. I may declare that I am here to transmit this enlightenment experience to you. But people expect that I should heal their physical pain, mental pain. I should bless them for wealth. I should bless them for a healing relationship. Peace, bliss, contentment, completion. See, the other's image, what people perceive from me and expect from me, maybe it is different than what I declare, but even then I am responsible. Because whatever they expect is within the purview of my declaration. Please understand. When I say I am here to transmit that experience to you, to give that experience to you, I have to give you at least 1000 volt spiritual energy. But to clear your cancer or headache, I need to give only 0.5 volt energy. So if you expect me to heal your physical problems, I am responsible for it, because that falls in the purview of my declaration. Anything which can be done by the transmission of energy and experience of enlightenment, the side effect, after effect, byproduct of transmission of energy, you have a right to expect from me, because that comes within the purview of my declaration. It is my responsibility to fulfill it. Only if you expect that I should win the World Cup playing the football match, I am not responsible for it, because that doesn't come under my declaration, the purview of my declaration. But anything you expect in the line of physical health, mental health, complete relationships, wealth, fulfillment, completion, enlightenment, I am responsible for it. Either I have to give you that. If you are not ready to receive, I have to prepare you and give you that. But till you achieve it, I am responsible. This is what is taking responsibility for others' image. And the life image, the image I have about life and others, the whole world is here to celebrate this joy with me, to celebrate this bliss with me, to celebrate this completion with me. That's all. So understand, now you also look in and find out the inner image you have, outer image you project, others' image you created, for which you are responsible, and life image you are having about life and others. Pen down exactly what you have. Then we will find out the root cause of all the problems you have in your life. Then we will build the right inner image, outer image, life image, others' image. Come on. First, let's spend a little time in finding the inner image you are having, outer image you are having, others' image you are having, life image you are having, without editing. Please start penning down. Please distribute the assignment sheet of genesis of your identity. Now I wanted to give you some deeper insights based on your introspection, your internalysis, your contemplation. How many of you found in your experience, listen carefully, how many of you found in your experience there is a gap between how you think about you and how you show you? Means gap between inner image and outer image. Raise your hand. If there is a gap between inner image and outer image, how you think of you and how you project you to others, in this gap, self-doubt starts. Understand? For example, you go to attend an interview, you know you are not capable of something, but you show, you sell yourself to your boss, saying, I can do it. And boss is convinced, and he gives you the job. When you come back, suddenly you feel, you convinced others, but you yourself are not convinced. Then what is the truth? The doubt about yourself starts raising, which will start coming up in every level of your life. In your health, in your relationship, everywhere this doubt will start raising. That is what I call self-doubt. How many of you think you have this self-doubt? Raise your hand. We will have to now find that and complete. Second, how you project yourself to others, outer image, how others perceive you, others' image. You may project yourself very humble person, simple person. Others will say, see, this fellow acting. You may project as a humble, simple person. Others will say, see, this fellow, how he is acting. How many of you have experienced this? Raise your hand. You may project yourself in one way, others completely perceive in a different way. Raise your hand. Let me see the gap between outer image and others' image. Listen. When others perceive you in a different way, you naturally start feeling you are not enough unto yourself. You will start feeling, I am not enough. That is the source of all the self-hatred. Please understand, self-hatred. When you project yourself in some way, but others perceive in some other way, when you become powerless about it, and you feel kind of, you start hating yourself, I am not enough, I am not sufficient, others are not believing how I am projecting me. That is self-hatred. Next. Listen. Next. How many of you feel that you have this self-hatred? Raise your hand. You feel you are not enough. Raise your hand. Let me see. Yes. That is self-hatred. We need to find out this source of this and complete with it. Third, this is the very important thing. Others' image, how others expect you. Life image, how you expect others. See the fun. Everyone around you will be telling you should understand people more. You should be more listening. You should have more understanding. But you will strongly believe everyone around me are incomplete. They should understand me more. You will believe everyone around you are incomplete. And they don't understand anything. They should understand you and transform themselves. But they will all believe you are incomplete. You should understand them more and transform. How many of you have this tug of war? Raise your hand. This is what I call self-denial. Whatever is denying it, constant denial. The gap between what you think about others and what others think about you. This gap makes you start denying everything. See, when you want everyone to understand you and change, and everyone around you wants you to understand and change, there's a deadlock. And you become powerless. You don't do anything. This becomes a lifestyle. Time passes, day passes, you don't think. You don't walk that extra mile you need to walk. You constantly live in denial. All breakdown in life happens in denial. Understand? All breakdown happens in self-denial. How many of you think you have self-denial? Now it is time. You sit and pen down all the self-doubt you have, self-hatred you have, self-denial you have. S-D-H-D. Like ADHD for kids, SDHD for grown-up kids. SDHD patterns. I wanted all of you to spend little time now and understand the self-doubts you have and the incidents when it started in you. Self-hatred you have and incidents when it started in you. Self-denial patterns you have and incidents when it started in you. Start. SDHD. Start penning down. We internalized about the inner image we have, outer image we have, life image we have, others image we have, which is very inauthentic. That is why you have so much of SDHD, self-doubt, self-hatred, self-denial. Let us contemplate the inner image you want to have and pen down. The outer image you want to have and pen down. Others image you want to have and pen down. Life image you want to have and pen down. Please listen. What you have is inauthentic. What you want to have, if you pen down, you will see authenticity there. I'll explain after you write what you want to have, how to have what you want to have. First, think through and pen down what you want to have. The best inner image you want to have, best outer image you want to have, best others image you want to have, best life image you want to have. Please pen down. Please pen down. Now please listen. After all this internalysis, you will now know very clearly what are the patterns which is stopping you becoming what you want to be. Means the gap between your inauthentic image and authentic image. For example, your authentic image, you may want to get up every day early morning 5 o'clock and do yoga, but your inauthentic image, early morning when 5 o'clock alarm bell rings, no, you don't want to get up, tired, feeling sleepy. Then what is it stopping you becoming authentic? Your tiredness, boredom. When you started developing this, your tiredness and boredom is the incompletion. When you started developing it, find the incidents. Same way, in your authentic image, you want to be just fearless. Want to go for a beautiful night walk in the moonlight, in full moon day, in the forest. But the inauthenticity creates fear. Fear of animals, ghosts, and what not. So what is it that stops you living your authenticity? The fear pattern. So pen down your incompletion, and when those fears started in you. How many of you understand what I am saying? Please raise your hand. So understand, all the incompletion patterns which stops you living your authentic image. What stops you living your authentic inner image, outer image, others image, life image? The past thoughts, emotions, patterns, hangovers, residues, sitting in the present and suffocating you, not letting you live your future, is incompletion. The past thoughts, emotions, patterns, hangovers, residues, sitting in the present and suffocating you, not letting you live your future, is incompletion. So understand, think and look in, pen down at least 11 incompletions. You must be having 11,000, that's different. At least 11, pen down. The 11 incompletions stopping you becoming authentic, and the incidents when those incompletions started in you as early as you remember. Pen them down. I bless you all. Let's all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching and causing eternal bliss. Nityananda.
நித்யானந்த தியான பீட்டம், நித்யானந்த நகர், ஆஃப் மைசூர் ரோட், பிடதி, பெங்களூரு. ஃபோன் 08027279999. www.nityananda.org www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.